Of all the ancient same-sex myths, Zeus and Ganymede follows closest a tradition that started as a rite of passage in ancient Crete, where there were no taboos against homoeroticism. For the Cretan boy, passage into adulthood was not a traditional wedding to a girl, but a mock wedding with masculine rituals to a mature person of his own sex who won the object of his love not by persuasion, but by abduction. The lover told the friends of the boy beforehand that he was going to make the abduction, but if the boy's friends concealed him, it was a disgraceful thing, an admission that the boy was unworthy to obtain such a lover and mentor. When they met, if the abductor was the boy's equal or superior, the friends pursued the boy and detained him in a very gentle way, thus satisfying the custom, and they cheerfully turned the boy over to him. If the abductor was unworthy, they took the boy away from him. After giving the boy numerous, costly presents, the abductor led him away. Those attending the abduction followed, and after hunting and feasting with them for 2 months, they returned to the city and the boy was released. One day, a Trojan boy, the handsomest of all mortal men, was practicing throwing the javelin, wrestling, diving, and other Olympic games with his playmates on Mount Ida near Troy. Born on the wide plain at the foot of Mount Ida, son of King Tros of Dardania, Zeus's own grandson, this child, a golden-haired boy named Ganymede, grew into a limber youth and a skilled hunter. Zeus, who had loved him from afar since first laying eyes on him, spotted an opportunity as Ganymede, exposed on the sacred slopes without refuge, set Zeus's majesty aflame with his thighs. Black clouds coiled about the flanks of Mount Ida. At once, casting shafts of lightning every which way, he whipped up a fierce tempest, turning day into night. Ida boasted dark clouds that veil the love-smitten Zeus, who takes guise of an eagle, for no bird would he deign to be but one that had the power to bear his thunderbolts. Could resist no more. From loft descended and pouncing on his prey, with crooked talons bear the boy away. The darling boy was borne aloft on tawny wings as the Dardanian promontory sank downwards as he rose, and Troy grew dim beneath him. Without delay, Zeus beat the air with his deceiving wings, and upon reaching Olympus landed, tucked both wings, and turned back into the god. Ganymede's father was heartbroken upon hearing of the abduction of his golden-haired son. So Zeus sent Hermes with a gift of 12 divine horses as recompense, the same that carry the immortals, and word that his son was now eternally young and cupbearer for the gods, supplanting Zeus's own daughter, Hebe. Zeus carried off Ganymede to be amongst the deathless ones, to pour forth heaven's wine for the gods in the house of Zeus. A wonder to see, honored by all the immortals as he draws the brimming cups of ruby nectar from the golden bowl. Ganymede was the only one of Zeus's lovers granted eternal youth and immortality so that he may keep the lovely bloom of boyhood. The jealous Hera, driven into a rage, quarreled frequently with Zeus over the boy. The Phrygian boy paced with dainty step among the golden chalices, and he always filled high the cup of Zeus. The immortals esteemed the Trojan prince for his beauty and welcomed him with open arms, all except Hera. The queen of the gods drew back her hand, refused her nectar. Thirsting for revenge, she whipped all Greece into a frenzy against Ganymede's beloved Idaean homeland. As he looked on in horror, the Greek slaughtered his kin and the land of his birth is consumed by fire. Grateful for Ganymede's love, Zeus realized he must hide his favorite from the wrath of Hera, put Ganymede into the sky, disguised as the constellation Aquarius, and sent him to the far reaches of the universe. Zeus, no longer a tyrant, heedless of mortal happiness, when his longing to touch Ganymede overcomes him, reaches out across the sky to caress him with blue lightning bolts. Some lightning bolts reach for the earth and are the white ones we see. If you ever see a blue lightning bolt, follow it to its end, and you will see Ganymede.